In this video, we discuss about how to update the mixture weights in the formulation of the Gaussian mixture model. And the main result of this lecture is formulated in this theorem we have on the whiteboard, saying that the new values of the weights, pk, should be set to nk over n. And I want to prove this result to you. And the main starting point is the same as we had in the previous two videos. We are taking the log likelihood, and we are thinking in terms of maximizing the log likelihood, which obviously in particular it means that we should set the partial derivative of the log likelihood with respect to pk to be equal to zero. But there is an extra complication in this case, because we have a constraint. The sum of all of these weights should be equal to one. Remember that they can be thought of in some sense as a probability distribution mimicking the relative importance that each one of the Gaussian components plays for the overall mixture model. So we have to solve this optimization problem with constraints. So the extra constraint is this one, that the sum of pk from k with k from 1 to capital K, this one should be 1. And we had in one of our earlier videos a similar problem, and there is a standard solution to such a constrained optimization problem, and that is that we are going to go to Lagrange multipliers. And so what this means is that we are going to introduce a new function which is also including this constraint into the optimization problem we have to solve, and this turns it into an unconstrained optimization problem for which we can use calculus. So we are introducing a new function. I'm going to denote it with this L that has a double bar on this left-hand side. And this is going to be defined to be the log likelihood we had before, plus the usual way in which this constraint is being integrated in terms of Lagrange multipliers. In this case, because we only have one constraint, we only have one Lagrange multiplier, so we introduce this constant lambda. And the lambda is going to be multiplied by sum minus 1. And you might check our earlier videos on constraint optimization to see that indeed this was exactly the solution we had also at that time. And so what we do now is we now have we still have to maximize this function, and this time is an unconstrained optimization problem. There are no more constraints, but we pay a price in the sense that we have one extra parameter, and that's this lambda. And so this comes down to being equal to let me just maybe take this all the way here. So this is going to be, I'm just replacing who this log likelihood was. So this is a sum from 1 to capital N from log of, and here we have this other sum, k from 1 to capital K, pi k normal distribution, xn with mean mu k and covariance sigma k. And then we obviously have this second term, which is lambda sum of pi k minus 1. And so we need to maximize this function, which is going to lead to the idea that we have to take these partial derivatives. On one hand, we take the partial derivative with respect to pi k. And on the other hand, we are going to take the partial derivative with respect to lambda. But let me first do this one. So when I do the partial derivative with respect to pi k, from this side, this we have seen before, and what we are left with is sum from 1 to n, and then we have the partial derivative of this big log. And that's going to be normal distribution of xn with mu k sigma k over sum with j from 1 to capital K, pi j, normal distribution xn with mu j and sigma j. And then from the from this term, when we take the partial derivative with respect to pk, then obviously we are only left with one lambda. The other terms are going to be equal to zero. And what we have now is, I'm writing this as 1 over pi k times sum from 1 to n, pi k, so this pi k is just cancelling out, but it's convenient for me to write it in this way, pi k normal distribution xn given mu k and sigma k over the sum with j from 1 to capital K of pi j normal distribution of xn with mu j and sigma j. And this is, you might recall from one of our, obviously there is a plus lambda here, so this is this term. But this sum, this is what we have defined as being nk. So this, in the end, comes down to be nk over pi k plus lambda. And on the other hand, if I take the partial derivative of this special L with respect to lambda, this is in fact quite easy because this whole term, when I take the partial derivative with respect to lambda, it goes down to zero. And so I'm only left with this sum from 1 to k, ik minus 1. And so now we are setting both partial derivatives to be equal to zero. So if I'm taking this to this slide, so once I'm setting this to be equal to zero, and this one to be equal to zero, what this implies is that I get pi k exactly equal to minus nk over lambda, and we also get that the sum from 1 to capital K by pk, this has to be equal to 1. And so what this means is that if I'm just replacing all of the pk's in this sum, what this means is that minus sum from 1 to capital K by nk over lambda, this has to be equal to 1. And what this is equivalent with, remember that the sum of these nk, this was denoted by n, so we are getting down to minus n over lambda is equal to 1. And so this is equivalent with lambda being equal to minus n. And so when I'm coming now with lambda here, then I'm getting that pi k should be exactly equal to, and I have a minus here in lambda, and it's canceling out with this other minus. So pi k, and I should write here nu, so the solution to this problem is exactly equal to nk over n. And that's exactly what the theorem was saying. And again, the idea here is that we are going to update these values, and the mixture weight that is given by this theorem is really the ratio of the total responsibility of the kth cluster and the number of data points. And pk can also be interpreted, if you think about this formula, what does it mean? It can also be interpreted as the relative importance that the component k has in the overall mixture model for this data set that you are investigating now. And for our example, I'm just reproducing the numbers from the textbook. This time I'm not going to show it visually because it's less informative than in the other cases. But the example, if you were to calculate these updates, you would come down to the idea that pi 1, it used to be 1 over 3, and is now, you know, once you calculate this, you get this new assignment. It's 0.29. And pi 2, this was also set to start with to be 1/3, and it is also now being updated to 0.29. And pi 3, you had it to start with 1/3, and now the suggestion is that you should update it to 0.42. So the way to really read this is that we started with a mixture model where the three components had equal contribution to the overall model. And after we examined the data set, we come down to conclude that as a first update, we should update the first two components to have less importance than they had before. And we are increasing the importance of the third component from 1/3 to 0.42. And with this, we are now ready to discuss the overall procedure of how to put this all together into an iterative procedure. And that's going to be the topic of our next video.